Hello and welcome to Real Hi-Fi Help with this week's edition of Real Music Vault number 2. So we're continuing the tradition on spotting some really good individual songs that most people don't really know of. So let's start it off with this George Michael song. Stop it there, and you guys can always find it on YouTube. But I really like this George Michael song. I'm not really a George Michael fan, but when he makes a reasonably straight song, and you don't get this moaning stuff going on, I find that when you get up in this type of class of music, it gets really a lot more enjoyable, and I just thought of showing that to you guys because it has this sense of class that you normally don't relate to George Michael. So try that, and let's just go to the last George Michael song, another one I also found really interesting, where he really connects with the message, the emotions. Stop it there, and guys, you can always find it on YouTube. But I just thought that was really, really nice with a vulnerable George Michael song, really, you know, hitting the true feelings instead of that, you know, that it has a tendency of getting into that blame mode, like when you listen to the lyrics of Last Christmas, which gets a bit weird and overly gay-ish. I really like this one. It just somehow connects. And an unusual one I found from an artist called Lene Marlin. I don't really know what to call this type of song, but I just thought that was really nice, really special, and again really classy, not going over to that mainstream popular kind of music where you kind of slaughter the whole thing. So yeah, very stylish, very musical. Let me take another one here. This has got to be one of the most special versions of Buckethead's Soothsayer live versions. Buckethead, I don't know what to say about him. He's obviously one of the most talented guitarists in the world, and you'd never know listening to it on your computer. I would recommend for anyone who wants to listen to really hardcore, truly highly gifted guitar solo music, Go and buy a Buckethead album. Apparently, he's made like a lot of tracks throughout the years, and he has a very special way of playing. It's very hard to describe. You almost have to listen to it to yourself. But I'm just telling you, the guys, that there's a lot of hidden good stuff on this track here. So do yourself the favor, if you can at all, listen to this version on a high-quality streamer, on a high-quality audio system. There is a lot of good stuff. And also generally in his songs, they can seem as if they're very two-dimensional and synthesized and fake. But trust me, once you get a decent recording like this one, it can actually sound very sophisticated. So here we go, Buckethead, Soothsayer Live.
Thank you.
drop it there, and guys, you can try and find it on YouTube. A lot of the versions on YouTube are filmed on pretty bad cameras, so this is one of the few ones that are really good. But just want to say about Buckethead is that I find it amazing how when you start listening to his music, you discover that there's a lot of tracks that are like 6, 8, 12, or around 20 minutes long with Buckethead. And he has this unusual ability to go in a direction where you think, oh, this is not going anywhere. And then suddenly he just shifts it into a gear that you just haven't heard before, you know? I just find it amazing the amount of different sounds that this guy can create with basically just the same instrument. I mean, he has a lot of foot pedals and stuff like that to manipulate the sounds, but I find it just amazing the amount of gears that this guy has. But I have to say that there's a lot of freaky stuff out there that isn't necessarily the same high quality as this particular song, but you definitely owe yourself the fortunate event of experiencing Buckethead for the first time. There are some few really awesome tracks with Buckethead, and I can imagine that when you own it on a CD or an LP, if he even makes that it's gonna sound a hell of a lot better. I mean, on my system, I only listen to this via YouTube on my system. I know that if I heard this version at a much higher quality, that it would just sound so much better. But yeah, enough of that. Let's go over to another one, a rare gem from The Cure. Just ended there, and I have to say this is one of the most sophisticated and musical songs from The Cure. They do make some pretty good songs sometimes, but I just found that this particular version, you should listen to it from start to end. It just has so many gears, just like in previous Buckethead song. Again, it's just that kind of sound that you don't really here nowadays, because after this, they basically made songs a lot more simple and popish. And in a way, some of those songs were still very good. I just missed going back to this particular song where it's just, it was an art piece, a true art piece, and especially this version. So try and listen to this version, very special. And a very, very underestimated band that has made some few really high quality songs. You owe this to yourself to get a Budgie album called, what was it called? Never Turn Your Back on a Friend. Get that on LP if you have a decent sound system. That is a truly remarkable album. It's actually pretty expensive, but maybe you can get one used. But such, it just has a certain type of sound that you don't really hear anymore. And a lot of people around this time were raving about, I don't know, Black Sabbath, Led Zeppelin, stuff like that, which also were very good in a different way. I just thought this Welsh band, Budgie, have some few good songs that are just really awesome, especially from this album. There's also Parents on this album that you should try and give a listen to. So here we go.
So that moon and sky above me, these are things I treasure most. So that lights my way goes on and on and on. Simple things will not be lost. You know
band, and you just have to experience this on vinyl in order to properly enjoy it. But they made a really awesome album, and actually this isn't the only album that they've made that's pretty good. I think all in all they've probably made like 10 albums, and at least four of them are just awesome, really top class music that you don't really get to hear from other bands. So, and they have some pretty high quality guitar playing going on there. So that was all for this version of Real Music Vault. So take care, bye.